What can you get out of the market? The three things that you would need.
I don't even know, but that's a cold situation.
Three things? You need those three things?
I don't even know. I like the Hennessy.
I love the Hennessy.
Jackie's getting Hennessy.
My three things are water. Definitely water.
Yes.
So my three things that I would need out of the market would be rice. I really enjoy rice. I can eat a long time with rice.
No grits.
What is red? We get grits. I would get rice.
But you gotta cook it. You got a stove?
I have a stove in my house. For three weeks.
You have like we gonna be a survivor.
It's kind of like Survivor. 2 weeks, you're hunkered down in your house. I can boil the water in my house. The pipes, the water still works, right? So if I could have some, if I got some rice, I could give me some beans, right?
Okay.
And some hand sanitizer. I've been looking for hand sanitizer for the past 2 weeks, guys. Those would be the three things. I give me some Purell. I got some rice and beans. I'm straight for those 3 weeks. And then I'll go over to my sister's house and drink some of her Hennessy.
Here we go.
We're good to go. Call us, guys. 310-910-9676. Extension 1.
So you know Flossie, I don't know what he would get. Flossie, what would you get?
He would get some peanut M&M's. You get some
Big
peanut
Flossie M&M's. Get some candy. Mm-hmm. Easy, Floss. I'm going to put that out there on you like that. Anyway, guys, we're going to have a good time. Yes, Ricky, that's what we've been doing here. But okay, guys, welcome back to the Poetry of Justice Show with Jackie Ray Phillips on Yikes Radio and AccelerateRadio.net. But what I'd like to do at this time is when we come back to the show, is I'm going to give a shout out to none other than the G. Lou Show, the fabulous G. Lou Lowrider Oldie Show. is on Sunday nights, and you've got an amazing cast on that show. You've got Big Flossie Stevenson from Long Beach. You've also got the amazing and beautiful Queen Jean, and then you've also got Hangsta the Gangster. So it is a great platform for everybody on those Wednesday nights. And then on Thursday nights, you've got the Tweet Cadillac Show. And then Friday nights, you've got Flashback Fridays with the Jean Lu Show. And then on Saturday nights, now you also now have the Jean Lu Podcast. So we've been doing some great, yay, right? It don't stop. It just don't stop. So we've done a great collaboration between the Jean Lu Show and the Poetry of Justice Show. And now, everybody, we've got on the ground a new show that I'm doing called The Critique. The Critique Show. So it is The Critique Show with Jackie Ray Phillips. It's just a podcast right now, and it's just for the love of music. So right now it's powered through Anchor, and we just launched that. And so today I had a chance to do my very first interview. So I was on that, you know, on our little Critique Show. So I was able to interview the fabulous Jean Lu, and I think word on the street is I might be able to get Long Beach Finest. I'll be able to interview him, but I'm not going to put it out there yet. Okay, I'm going to put it out there, guys. I'm calling out Big Flossie, so I'm hoping Big Flossie will let me interview him on our next show, though. So we've got a lot of fun and exciting things going on in the Poetry of Justice Show. So thank you to everybody. Dante, I missed you. I think we need to discuss that at some point during the show. We didn't have you for the last couple of weeks. How are you?
I'm well. Actually got a new internship.
Alright. Awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Have you been enjoying it?
I've been loving it. The first week they gave me Laker tickets. And I was like, wow, this is the
like this is some real stuff.
Ever, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So first time seeing LeBron play since he's been in a Laker uniform. Just taking all the blessings in. Very excited.
Yes, you deserve them all.
Last year at this time, remember I tore my Achilles. So it was a complete 360.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, well, welcome back.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So, though I know you did your rounds about the coronavirus.
No, it's fine. When you're looking at me like,
we did all of that, guys, and I don't really want to talk about that because that just kind of puts me in a funky mood, and I don't really want to do that. So, I want to go ahead and move on to some of our questions. Ricky, 88 fingers.
Yes.
What does the word fairness mean to you? Fairness.
Well, my sign is a Libra, which means balance. And fairness to me would be everybody having the same opportunity. It's just being even with opportunity.
What about you, Kyle?
I would say it's an agreement where everybody's satisfied. Like something, not that like something has to, there has to be anything negotiated, but like an action can happen and you can take that action agreement that then be satisfied with it and how it was played out. And I think that's fair.
Kyle, do you think fairness is different per situation?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Could it be like this person thinks this is fair, but another person would not?
Definitely.
You know what
definitely.
I mean?
And those other people, I would say, like, don't agree. And they usually, I don't know, counteract it.
Okay. Dante, what about you? Fairness.
Didn't expect that to happen.
I know, it's that cool.
I think fairness looks like, to me, would be, like you said, balance and agreement. Definitely something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I can see those things. I think if fairness is also something that doesn't always come our way, mm-hmm. so it's not really.
Right.
It's not really a subjective or objective thing. It's really like changes in different situations. It's not always applicable. It's not always what we want it to look like. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
That's what I was wondering about. But then, so how does that transcend into justice? If we look at our definitions for fairness, like even an opportunity saying, right? You know what I'm saying? I'm wondering, how does that fall, kind of filter into the word justice? What does the word justice mean to you right now?
Wow. I think if things were fair, then justice would be more acceptable.
Justice, what does that mean to you guys? Does it lie with fairness?
I think a lot of times it appears unfair when things aren't fair. But we usually relate justice as like a retaliation to something that happened to somebody when somebody was wronged and they feel that there needs to be justice because something was done to them that they feel was unfair. But justice is in a positive light because I feel like we always view it as in like there's something negative that's happened and so now there needs to be justice. But I think it could be interesting to look at justice as something that like exists outside of negativity and where there can could just be fairness existing, and that could be just simple justice when everything's in agreement, which is something we can only talk about, but it's only like a hypothetical situation just because the world is how the world is. But yeah, I just think the definition of justice is just, I would say, when, going back to what I said about fairness, when there's like an agreement and that agreement is broken, and then justice is what's done to like mend that break.
We have a call on the air, guys. Hello, call, you on the air. I'm good now, low-key. I was, like, feeling some kind of way because I was like, you hadn't called yet, so, yeah. Yay! I love you, Roddy Rod. How you doing tonight? Well, I gotta give our lady some eye candy, too. We don't really have male viewers. We got the lovely Lori G, the benefactor of the house.
Hey, Roddy Rod.
I know you're used to the ladies at a chat. You'll see them next week. So you
next week.
Kind of shit going on next week. We have some wild women in here. And you see this fool. I love you too, Rod. Are you taking care of yourself? You're looking good out there. You doing good? You rock. So much. All right, I'll talk to you soon. When are you coming back? When are you coming back to the station? So much, Rob. We love you.
Love you, Rod. Take care.
All right, talk to you soon. All right, guys, let's get it back on track. You know what I was going to ask? You know what I want to do? I'm going to do something. Dante, can we do a course? I'm going to pull up the Archer. Because I want to share my work with my amazing guest tonight. You know what I'm saying? Can I do that?
Yeah.
I was like, yeah. Yeah, we're going to do it. We're going to do the remix. Do the remix one. Yeah. Thank you.
Still missing you so much. Candid episodes as fruition unfolds. The ability to see deep within me. Creation, he began. Time before human. Simplicity explodes. Intricate as a cell of the lymph nodes. Engraved. Teardrop stained, not a chance. Smiles remain as the victory dance across my face, filling my space. Methodical movements, knowing it's heaven sent. Burning is the flame, colorful but tame. Elevation is the game, never quite remain the same. Constant acceleration without hesitation. Knowing to make a move, position in the groove. Striking back is the blow. Landing strategic is the bow. The hunter, the hunter, the hunter. The gift. Recognizing and accepting the shift. It happens, it happens, it happened to me. Another spark of my curiosity. Blending neatly deep within me. But don't you think?
The two of you about.
You used to write.
Remember?
You used to write stuff in this. But it was raggedy.
Yeah.
Oops, did I say
yeah.
Candy?
Yeah.
You know, it
remember?
Raggedy, you know,
remember?
And all these writings. Yeah, I do remember.
I still have those.
When I was looking, I just said, oh wow, that looks.
See? Do you remember when you guys wished to go? I'm exposing you guys now. Remember I said I had some revenge? This is the one. You remember when you guys would read my freaking diary? You don't, Lori, you, oh,
I had
it was Richard.
Justice
and fairness, right, Dante?
It was Richard who read it. That's who it was.
They wouldn't read
it. It wasn't Ricky, Richard read it.
I would do Ricky's, you see, and then I write my little stat, and I don't know what I was thinking. I would hide it in front of them.
That's what I'm saying, you would leave it right there. Like you wanted us to
She wanted someone to read it, right?
Yeah.
It needed to be read.
So then eventually I graduated from my little raggedy notebook to one with a lock.
With a lock, I remember.
And then you guys infiltrated that one.
I remember that.
You remember that? I see it.
It was your idea to use the Barbie pen to pick it open.
You see what I have to go to? What was I supposed to do, Kyle? That was a good time.
Wow.
Thank you. Remember, right? Wow. Yeah, that was a long time ago. I love writing. I just wanted to take that ride back. Thank you, Ricky. That was a really cool moment with those guys. I've got some more social justice. You guys want to talk some more social justice, or you want to talk about something more exciting? What do you want to do? Okay. Alrighty. How do you feel? I'm going to go with Kyle. How do you feel arts and music relate to social justice and social consciousness? Could it? And how do you think it's been used? And do you use it in any way with your work?
Art and music relate to social justice and consciousness. I think definitely, like, it's one of the more genuine forms of communication about social justice. I mean, you can see people, you can see things on social media that will, you know, their intention, but like as a consumer of it, it's just the way you consume it, like in places like social media, it might not be as impactful, but I think when it's infused with art, which is really personal, and people are really putting their foot in things, basically, and really trying to, like, art makes it more convincing, I feel like, of a message, because of how personal art is, mm-hmm. and like, it comes from within, and then you share it with other people. So I feel like all matters like social justice, it's more powerful. Mm-hmm. It's definitely a good thing. I've written songs before about, like, I wrote one called Freedom Rollin'. It's like an entendre, like, for the Freedom Riders, mm-hmm. and dedicated to Trayvon Martin. I wrote it as kind of just like a way of healing, almost, when Trayvon died. I haven't released it yet, but I do plan to put it on an album that I'm working on.
Yes.
But, something I perform, when I perform it, it still serves this purpose of just like healing, and it's bringing awareness to that. And like, even when I perform it, it feels genuine, you know, like it's not, it's harder to sweep it under the rug when you compare it with art, because art is something I feel like people generally take more for what it is without trying to, you know, like place their own emphasis or place their own layers on top of it. Right. Yeah.
What about you, Richard? And then you were going back to the arts and music and how it relates to social consciousness.
Well, I think music and art, people are able to, let me see, the best example for me would be, this is Hollywood, and actors, they go into character, and sometimes they're able to express themselves as a character better than they are when they're trying to express themselves as who they really are. Mm-hmm. And sometimes art gives us the freedom to go into a place and be more than what we would feel comfortable mm-hmm. in society acting out or mm-hmm. allowing people to see that side of us. But I know for me, when I'm on stage, I can go wherever I want to, and I'm sitting there laughing, and I can care less what the people are hearing, because it's like, oh, wow, look at where I'm at right now. Did y'all hear that? And then when I hear people respond, I'm able to go, okay, I'm going to go farther. Okay, right. Let me see how much
it's gassed up.
Right, so I think art allows us to say a lot more than what, if people are connected and if they are in tune, all of a sudden they would go. I have so many people come to me afterwards and say, now you were somewhere else. You wasn't. Mm-hmm. I know, I saw what was going on, but it's something else mm-hmm. you're trying to say. And so it opens the door for other conversations that I normally cannot have, because you have to be politically correct.
Right.
You know, yes. Certain things you can't say because you offend people, and you can't offend people now. So it opens the door for a greater conversation.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes. Oh my God. Nina Simone's work is popping in my head. What do you think about her work? And we'll go both ways. How her work and how it changed in her times. Social justice. Like, for instance, her work was Strange Fruit. We have a caller. I'm sorry, caller. We have a caller. You're on the air. Hello, Big. How you doing, Big Flossies? You doing good?
Today.
Let me say hey to Big Flossie.
Hey, Big Flossie. How you doing?
We doing good. We got Long Beach Finest on the phone, everybody. This gentleman, he's a really good gentleman, a good dude. He's, anyway, what do you think about him, Dante? We got Big Flossie on the line.
Love Big Flossie. What's up?
Thank you. All right, y'all got toilet paper? Okay, no, go ask Flossie. Ask Flossie okay. Right now, because we was going to ask
Flossie.
You.
At the break, you know, I did my shenanigans. And so the crazy hysteria about finding things at the market. So if you could go into the market and you could only pick up three things to survive the coronavirus outbreak, what would be those three things?
3 weeks.
That's for 3 weeks.
I'm done.
What? I can't hear. I don't have my ear.
I'm so done. Did you hear?
I can't hear.
Yeah. Oh, he's going to get vitamins. condoms and alcohol.
All right, Flossie, my man. There you go. All right, Floss, there you go.
Of course. I love you so much. Thanks, Flossie. Oh, my God. So, Flossie, let everybody know what you're going to be doing tomorrow night. What's up with that? It's a theory, conspiracy theory, which I'm thinking. We're not even going to go there. We'll have to tune in tomorrow night to the G Lou show.
Tune in to the G
Lou
show.
And then we'll find out, because Flossie B is going to let us know his thoughts on that, huh? Absolutely, absolutely. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. That's I love it. That's the G Lou Show with Big Flossie, everybody. You guys got to check that out tomorrow night. Thank you so much. All right. Talk to you soon.
Take care, Flossie.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys. We're back on the air. Thank you so much, Big Flossie. We appreciate that. Lori, okay. So we're going to talk about the coronavirus. You and that three.
That was a good controversial thing, right?
I know.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Ah. I don't know, Laura, but just looking at this text message, and it's a little wild. I don't know. But anyway, we're going to just kind of freestyle, and I don't know. If that's
the right one? Yeah.
Yeah, here are the list of questions we would ask.
That's what you sent me.
Okay, no worries. I think we pretty much covered most of the social justice questions that I had, more or less, you know what I mean? I think that's what I've done. But what I did want to do is I wanted to get back into a little bit more of Ricky's work. Richard, we have some more of your pieces. I would love for us to be able to enjoy that and our listeners. What do you think you should have Dante pull up for us?
Volume 1, Baby Beats.
This is Richard Elliot.
One of these.
Strip club song. That's the booty song.
That's a Janet Buster, right?
Yes. Ricky, you said wow. Lori G, you said wow.
I said wow.
You had a couple of moments of memory?
Just a couple.
Just a couple of those
just
flashbacks.
Just a couple of flashbacks.
Got a little razzle dazzle.
Razzle dazzle. I'm back now.
Kyle, what kind you want to do another piece?
Let's
do it.
Yeah, sure.
Listen at that. I think you did all 88 times too on that one.
That's amazing.
Yeah. You put your.
You really feel your playing. I can feel your music.
Soulful.
Definitely.
Soulful.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Big snap. Great work.
You can do precedent. It's always nice to like write something and like produce it here, and then usually I like do it all in one session, and it's nice like to wake up. But sometimes you can be feeling it, and then you wake up in the morning and it's, I don't know about that.
Right.
But like this, it's nice to know like the next morning the tracks that you just stick are the ones that you still like the next morning. Like some people call it like the morning after test, see if you still like it.
What about you, Rick? Have you had that experience?
Yeah, it takes me longer. It seems like it takes me about a year to do something.
Mm-hmm.
Because of my perfectionist. Too much of a perfectionist. And because I never play the same thing, I have to figure out what I'm going to use.
Mm-hmm. Never play the same thing?
Yeah, it's very rare to play the same thing. Depends on the mood, depends on the day, depends on what's going on.
Right. So it's literally a masterpiece before you allow it to be released.
Yes. Like it's like a conversation. You know, you never have the same conversation. You can use the same words, but it's not the same conversation.
Where'd you learn that?
I just learned it.
It's kind of picked up.
Yeah, I was just wondering, like, did any of your, like, your teachers before you or any of that, you know what I mean?
I just got that now.
I just want you guys to go ahead and call if you can let everyone know your handles. Oh, we have a phone call.
Hello, Collie, you're on the air.
Hello, beautiful Queen Jean. How are you tonight?
Thank you.
We love you, Queen Jean. So you ready? Getting your things ready for tomorrow night's show?
Yes.
Well, I'm going to be so excited to listen to it. I love you guys, and I love what you're doing. It's amazing work, Queen. So much. Appreciate it. So welcome. Thank you. Appreciate you calling so much.
Hey, Queen Jean. How you doing?
That's Lori Queen.
Mm-hmm. Oh, thank you, darling.
It's so pretty.
It is gorgeous.
I know. You too.
You too.
Okay, Queen. Bye-bye. I was going to tell you, we have one of our, Andre Bell, he's one of our followers right now with his live on Facebook. He says that his your work reminds him of early Kashif.
Oh,
have you, yeah. Have you gotten that before? Yeah. So I just wanted to share that with you so that just came live stream for us. So for those individuals who want to get your work and listen to more of Kyle's work, can you let everyone know how they can find him?
It's just Kyle Lux underscore, KYLELUX underscore.
Okay. Mr., where are you going to be performing again? What's happening with you, Mr. A?
They have shut down quite a bit everything.
That's true.
That's true.
I guess we'll be listening to radios.
I'm still in Palm Springs. I do Palm Springs twice a week at a spot called Dickies of Santa Fe.
Really?
In Indian Wells.
Oh, is it like a little casino kind of? Tell us about it. Describe it.
It's a lounge and a dinner club. And one side is dinner, the other side is music. They have music 7 days a week. The good thing is there's no screen on the wall for people to watch TV while they're listening to music, like in most places. We still use live band. I play a 9-foot grand piano.
Wow. I know you have a good time. That is amazing for you.
That reason alone is worth the drive. Because every place, you know, has gotten rid of the pianos, including the churches.
Wow.
So to play a live piano, it helps keep me up.
Who you are, you know what I'm saying? I know. Yeah, I guess with everything that's going on with this virus, I don't know, you guys, we're going to be able to make it happen. So, Lori, you want to let everybody know what we got going on next week as we near the ending of the show?
Yes, next week, the Ladies of the Chat will be back, and the Ladies of the Chat are producing a Motown review.
Mm-hmm.
So you guys, make sure you join us. You're going to be able to hear the sounds of Motown, but you know how the ladies do it. You're also going to hear the history. And Shelly C has all the tea about Motown.
Oh my goodness.
Current and past tea.
Is the, what could possibly currently be going on, but I guess.
You know, Shelly C, she knows. She has the past, present, and sometimes the future.
Shelly's got that vision of that extra.
She does.
What's up next for you, Kyle?
I have 3 shows coming up canceled, so now I'm just
fucking A, dude. yikesradio.com.
Just working on music.
So you just kind of, I don't know, guys. I'm kind of, I'm not worried, but it's just like weird. You know what I mean? It's just weird, kind of. Like going to the grocery store today and nothing's on the shelf. Hello, caller, you're on the air. Hello, hello. Hello, the fabulous G Lou. How are you doing tonight? Thank you so much. So I've told us, our platform, a little bit about what it is that you do and your crew, but we've been blessed with Big Flossie and Queen Jean, but for Brandon, I think it's, yeah. Could you let everybody know? Because it's different when you say it, you know what I mean? So go ahead and do what you do, please. Oh, thank you. Bless you. Thank you so much. Blessings to you too, Gila. We receive and thank you so kindly. Thank you, humbly. We thank you so much for calling the show. Alrighty, we will. Thanks so much. Richard, did you have a good time?
I had a wonderful time.
Alright, that sounds good. And coming from you, that means great deal. Mm-hmm. Kyle,
yeah.
What about you? Did you have a good time?
Yeah, it was fun. It was my first podcast or talk to.
See, your first. Lori, what's the song? Because I couldn't think of it earlier today. Please tell us.
I think it's like never as good as the first time.
Okay,
Sade.
Sade, do you remember that? Ooh. Please, Dante.
Yeah.
I was doing my interview earlier today with the fabulous G. Lou. I couldn't think of that to save my life. So we were talking about first, right? And so thank you so much. I'm
yay,
glad that
you
podcasting at its finest.
Mm-hmm.
You may not get this everywhere else.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're going to just outro with this, Dante. We're going to just take a ride, guys.